relatives. I'm tired. I'm about to enter my 69th winter, and I'm getting tired. You know, last July, my brother over here, Wayne Martin Sr., and myself, and others, and brother Kansas, he's over here too. We were trying to stop illegal alcohol to come in on our reservation, and our own police arrested us. Not only arrested us, but kind of worked us over in the meantime. It's, you know, this country has gone completely bonkers. It is, you know, you think that Hillary Clinton's going to save you? You think she's going to stop the war? Hell no! This country is, his entire economics is totally based on the armed forces of the United States of America. You get rid of the armed forces and you don't have an economy because they've shipped it all out, Democrats and Republicans.
Yes!
Understand, you cannot have a country that champions individual liberty like your Constitution does. You cannot have individual liberty if you only have two political parties.
Right?
You see, you know, I'm getting sick and tired. Why don't they have a national holiday to the Iroquois Confederacy, to the American Indian people who gave them the idea of individual liberty? Benjamin Franklin said it in 1746, 30 years before the American Revolution. He said, why can we, a more civilized people, form a more perfect union when those savages to the north have formed a near-perfect union that has endured for centuries? Consequently, they wrote the Constitution of the United States and the amendments championing individual liberty, because we taught it to the world. Not John Locke, not Plato, or any other white clown. You know, I'm getting sick and tired of the white privilege in this country that could just tell you lies, 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 and you go for it! It's over unless you do something! And I don't mean voting! Anything, it would be illegal. They should have a night. Instead, they got a national holiday to a slave trading, the first transatlantic slave trader. Why? Where are the black people, man? I'm 35 million of them should be here. They should be all over this country. Besides, 40% of them claim to be Indian. Where are they? We're getting sick and tired of everyone trying to be white. And I'm getting sick and tired of these goddamn statues.
You get this, right?
I live where genocide is happening every day. I invite all the policemen. I invite all of you up to Pine Ridge and come to the dumps. Come to around and see our children. And look at our families. We're dying at 44 years of age. There's only 8 countries in the world with a lower life expectancy than us, and they're all in Central Africa. But you take out AIDS and we have the lowest life expectancy in the world. And this is supposed to be the greatest country in the world. Don't tell me that! It's a police state. women stood up, when the homosexuals stood up, when the Chicanos stood up, when the blacks stood up. Into a police state, and that's what he's done.
Yes, sir. Amen.
And now, sir, I want you to understand that we can't allow this anymore, and we're not going to allow it anymore. Continually meeting here, begging the white man to please honor the rest of the humanity. Harry's going to torture you if you give him a chance.
Yes, sir.
And you know it. I grew up in a country that didn't have torture. Wouldn't be here. I'm 69, well, just about 69 winters old, you know. But I've got a heart. And I've got a responsibility. And my responsibility extends to the sacred colors, which also represent the human race. And who live upon our sacred grandmother, the earth. And that's the one thing. That's the one thing I want these Christians that are supporting us, the United Church of Christ, the Catholics, they better start telling their flocks that the earth lives. She's alive. You've got to stop the rape of the ultimate mother. And I'm on her side. I'm on her side. You know, curiously enough, because I am a true revolutionary, I want Bush to continue. I want him to declare martial law and continue. Because maybe it'll wake you up, and maybe these statues will start coming down.
Look, yeah.
Understand genocide. It's not just in pictures. It's real. It's real. You know, I've got a great grandson.